with Cartesian coordinate. I'm going to share one web page, okay, on this one. So in that Cartesian coordinate, how do I start? Yeah, I have to start first my unit vectors, am I right? Unit vectors and variables, x cap, y cap, z cap. What is the specialty of Cartesian coordinate? These unit vectors will not change wherever you go. But it is not the same case in case of spherical or other coordinate system. Is that okay? I mean, x cap, y cap, z cap are fixed in space. Okay, whatever the point in space you take, your unit vector will not change. So, what is the next one? Next one is, again, I think, how do I start? Yeah, yeah. So, any point that is represented by x, y, z, am I right? Any point that is represented by x, y, z, and position vector can be written as x cap plus y cap plus z cap. Obviously, you know this one, but I want to generalize this one to other coordinate. That's why I'm first writing this one, so that I will copy the same thing for other one. Okay. So similarly, I can write any vector in Cartesian coordinate as ax into x cap, ay into y cap, plus az into z cap. Can I write like this? Look at here. Any vector can be written like this. Okay. So next one is, again, what we need for our vector calculus. We have started with line integral, surface integral, volume integral. Am I right? To do line integral, you have to define dl vector. Okay. So dl vector, you have to define dl vector. To do surface integral, you have to define dA vector. Isn't it? So, so area element. Now, again, to do volume integral, you need to define volume element in Cartesian coordinate. Okay. Now, dl vector, we can write it as dx into x cap plus dy into y cap plus dz into z cap. Okay. dl vector, dx into x cap, dy into y cap, dz into z cap. So, now, the question comes, what is dA vector? It actually depends on the orientation of the area. Okay. But we prefer, I mean, we use this Cartesian coordinate only when there is that problem can be done easily in Cartesian coordinate. We have seen in case of cube, isn't it? Where its faces are either parallel to x-axis, y-axis or z-axis. I mean, so xy plane, yz plane like that, isn't it? So in that case, you can have, so three different, so can I write like this? Three different area vector. One is along x cap, other is along y cap, other is along z cap. Isn't it? So when it was along x cap, do you remember what are the variable? Dy, dz. When the plane is on yz plane, when the plane is yz plane or parallel to yz plane, your unit vector will be perpendicular to that one. What is the perpendicular direction to yz plane? X. Okay, depending on the situation, you have to choose this one. Okay, not only this one. Sometimes you have chosen minus x cap. Do you remember our earlier problem? There is no unique choice here. So similarly, dAy is equal to, I mean, it depends. Okay, it depends on the situation. Y cap, dx, dz. So dAz is equal to z cap, dx, dy. Let me just generalize this one later. Okay. So this whole pattern, so I'm going to generalize. What is d2? Dx, dy, dz. Am I right? That was very simple. So what else I need? Yeah. So next one, we define del t, isn't it? What is this one? Dou t by dou x into x cap, dou t by dou y into y cap plus dou t by dou z into z cap. Again, I'm writing whatever we know, then I have to slowly transform to other coordinate. Del dot v, divergence. So dou vx by dou x plus dou vy by dou y plus dou vz by dou z. and curl already known, isn't it? So let me write down, curl is equal to del cross V is equal to x cap, y cap, z cap, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, vx, vy, vz. Check it out. Obviously, we know all of this. Do you remember how I defined? Yeah, actually, after transformation, we defined r cap like that. So, using equations, wait a second. How do you define any unit vector? Any idea? Dou r by dou x by mod of dou r by dou x. Do you remember? Dou r by dou x. It's a vector along one particular one particular direction. Is that okay? So, in that one, again, you have to make it as a unit vector. We define like this, remember, r cap, we are going to define dou r by dou r, mod of dou r by dou r, isn't it? So, now, look at here, dou r by dou x, again, that denominator, we call that one as H1, H2, H3. So, did I introduce that one earlier in case of classical mechanics? Yeah. This denominator, what we call, I better write Hx, is that okay? Mod of dou r by dou x, let me call it as Hx. I think these are called as matrix tensor. Let me explain later. Dou r by dou x equal to Hx. Is that okay? So, that's why I can write. How do I write? X cap is equal to, or dou r by dou x is equal to hx into x cap. But when you take partial derivative, what is dou r by dou x? You will get x cap itself. That's why hx equal to 1. Or if you just take mod of dou r by dou x, what is dou r by dou x? X cap itself. Look at that. This one, isn't it? That is x cap itself. That's why mod of dou r by dou x, that's equal to hx, that's equal to 1. Is that okay? Same thing will happen for hy and hz. Is that okay? So, hx. So, similarly, y cap can be written as dou r by dou y divided by mod of dou r by dou y. I'm going to define dou r by dou y as hy, that's equal to 1. That's equal to 1. Similarly for z cap, write down all this. Because later we are going to write the same thing for spherical and other coordinate. Unit vectors. And you better to collect, whenever you write Cartesian coordinate, you better write like this, hx, hy, hz, they are equal to 1, 1, 1, they are 1. You will understand little bit later why I am writing like that, because to generalize it. Because you can't remember the same gradient divergence curl in the spherical or other coordinate system. That's why you better remember in terms of H. Okay. Now look at here. Yeah, I better to proceed. Then again, I'll come back and I'm going to discuss this one. Wait a second. Now I'll go for spherical polar coordinate system. Spherical polar coordinate system. And now, usually what we do, we start with the Cartesian, we are going to take transformation. isn't it? We start with the Cartesian we are going to transform that one. Spherical polar coordinate, isn't it? In the spherical polar coordinate, yeah, what is the transformation equation quickly? Speak out. X equal to? Speak out. R cos theta? R sin theta cos phi? Y equal to R sin theta sin phi? Z is equal to R cos theta. Am I right? Z equal to R cos theta. So once you write this, you know, obviously again, what is your R here? X square plus Y square plus Z square. Isn't it? What is your theta? Any idea? I think phi you can define it as tan. So, no. So theta, so theta here you can define. Am I right? Just take it out. So how do you define phi then? X by Y. Look at here. Yeah. Now we better draw the diagram. Then from the diagram we will get everything. Now the same point in space that is represented by R theta phi. What is R? Scalar distance from the origin. Distance from the origin. What is theta? Angle made with the Z axis. Am I right? What is phi? You have to take projection on XY plane. Then this is angle phi, isn't it? You have to take projection on XY plane. This is angle phi. Then what would happen here is, now look at here. So that's why, how do you define this? Now this is X coordinate. Okay. This is X coordinate. This is Y coordinate. Suppose if you just draw some perpendicular here, again, that perpendicular cannot be like this. Wait a second. Let me just draw it again, okay? Wait a second. It should be like this. Okay? So, this is Z cap. This is Z cap. This is the perpendicular. Can you see this one? X, Y, Z. Am I right? That was coordinate. So, that was coordinate. Now, how do you define phi now? You can define phi as tan inverse of. Look at here. Phi is equal to tan inverse of, or tan phi is equal to, how do you define opposite side by? Y by X. Am I right? This distance is Y. Can you just imagine this one? Any mistakes? Okay, so now this is Y again. If this is Y, this should be Y. I better to draw it a little clearly. Y cap. Okay, so now, so tan inverse of Y by X, theta is equal to, so tan in, so cos inverse of, cos inverse of Z by the root of X square plus Y square plus Z square. You better write like this, so that R phi and theta in terms, it's just inverting expression, am I right? X, Y, Z in terms of R theta phi in terms of X, Y, Z, inverting the expression. Is that okay? Again, we don't need this one much, okay? We don't need this one. Yeah. So, the next part here is, how do you write? Okay. So if you want to write any R, you can write again. X is R sin theta cos phi into X cap plus what is Y? R sin theta sin phi Y cap plus R cos theta plus R cos theta Z cap. Can you write like this? Now look at here. Your DL is nothing but DR actually. That, okay, whatever DL I have written, elementary displacement vector, that is nothing but DR, okay? How do you write DR actually? R vector that depends on, I mean, this position vector that depends on R theta phi. Am I right? Dou R by dou R into dr. Am I right? R vector is a function of R theta phi. So remember, R vector means position vector, isn't it? Any position, that's a function of R theta phi. That's what I'm writing. That's it. Okay. Now, plus dou R by dou theta d theta plus dou R by dou phi d phi. Is that okay? Do you remember what we have done? So we are going to play little clever step here. So that is dividing and multiplying by magnitude of this one. Okay. Mod, again, magnitude of this one, I better write it here. HR is equal to mod of dou R by dou R. Okay. H theta is equal to mod of dou R by dou theta. H phi is equal to mod of dou R by dou phi. Is that okay? So, again, if you're saying these are called as scale factors, okay? Scale factor, let me just check it out, okay? Or just see, I think he has given in the appendix part of this one. Or Weber book is the best one for all of this curvy linear coordinate, okay? He has given still more clear picture of how to define this unit vector, actually. Yeah. So now, so what I do here is, I'm going to divide it by HR, I'm going to multiply by HR. Okay. HR dou R by dou R divided by mod of dou R by dou R dr. Okay. So plus H, this is HR, but I'm writing it like this so that you can define this one as a unit vector. These two are equal. Similarly, H theta dou R by dou theta divided by mod of dou R by dou theta d theta plus H phi dou R by dou phi whole divided by mod of, I think we have done this one in classical mechanics, am I right? Same kind of thing, d phi. This is R cap, theta cap, phi cap, definition of unit vectors. Is that okay? So that's why, look at here, your displacement vector, what we call dl vector? Infinitesimal displacement, dl vector or dr. dl vector or this equal to dr, that's equal to hr, dr, r cap. Okay. Plus h theta, d theta, theta cap, plus h phi, d phi, phi cap. Check it out. H phi, d phi, phi cap. Is that okay? Now you need to find them. You need to find them. So using this expression. So what is this one? I think we already found this one. This was one. Do you remember? This was one. What is this one? Any idea? R. This was R. Just check it out using this expression. Okay? Dou R by dou theta. Again taking mod. So under root like that, this will be R sin theta. Check this out. And whenever you write spherical polar coordinate, you have to write HR, H theta, H phi. Why? You can write entire expression in terms of that. Whole expression can be remembered using those three. Is that okay? That's why dl vector in case of spherical polar coordinate, what is hr1 dr r cap plus what is h theta r d theta, theta cap, this is theta cap, r d theta, theta cap plus r sin theta d phi, phi cap. Check it out. Again, that theta and phi look like same, am I right? Okay. So that's why whenever you write spherical polar coordinate, you better to quickly remember this one, HR, H theta, H phi. Again, I'm going to extend with that. Is that okay? So next expression. Now, after this length, infinitesimal displacement vector, I try to define area vector. Am I right? Area element, or what we call infinitesimal area vector. So now again, it depends on the choice. It depends on the choice. The most used one is area vector along r cap direction. Is there okay? Area vector along r cap direction. It looks like this. Look at here. HR, then HR d theta d phi. No, that is H theta H phi d theta d phi. H theta H phi d theta d phi. What is this one? What is H theta R? H phi R sin theta. Speak up. D theta D phi R K. R square sin theta D theta D phi R K. What is this one? This is area vector along R K. Elementary area vector along R K. It needs some derivation. Okay. I have to take a sphere. In that sphere, I have to take one patch. From that one, I should try to, first I have to try to define its magnitude, actually. Okay, or I can define like this. Sin theta d phi was a solid angle, do you remember? I think using that one also we can define. So try to get some book, okay, so I think in Weber itself, we defined how to get this one exactly. Magnitude, isn't it? Direction we have decided. Now you have to take a sphere actually. On that sphere, you have to take one so patch of area. Then you have to define an angle. That becomes solid angle, sin theta, d theta, d phi. I think how does that r square come? We have to think over it. Isn't it? Just like how I defined area element in case of plane polar coordinate. That was very simple. Isn't it? Area element in a plane polar coordinate was very straightforward, but here it is three dimensional. Okay? Yeah. So we don't have to worry much. You better to take this one and you can proceed. Okay? And other area vectors are very less used. Along theta cap direction. So D A phi along phi cap direction. Most used one is this one. Okay? Because in spherical symmetry, we will not go for spherical coordinate if suppose our area vector is like this. We will avoid that one usually. So A theta, can you guess? HR H phi DR D phi. Look at here. Theta. Are you getting the mnemonics? HR H theta DR D theta phi cap. First write down phi cap, then write missing one, isn't it? Just observe that one, observe that pattern and remember like that, okay? So, but this is the most used one. So, think over it, okay? How to get that r sin theta, d theta like that? I think you can, okay? Yeah, anyway. So now look at here. Let me just slowly proceed here. Again, I have to draw the diagram. I haven't shown the unit vectors again. Anyway, you know that one. Now, the next one is, what is the next one? D2. Am I right? This D2, as I remember, it's a kind of a scalar triple product, okay? As I remember, I don't know how to write. I think you have to take triple product between this one and this one. R squared dr sine theta, d theta d phi. Either you have to take a kind of triple product between them. These are the elementary length vectors in individual component, am I right? If you take a scalar triple product, you will get that one actually. Is that okay? So now that will become, again, yeah, let me define it later anyhow. So r square sine theta dr d theta d phi. Dr d theta d phi, that is your elementary volume or infinitesimal volume element in case of spherical polar coordinate. It's a kind of triple product as I remember. But I couldn't get it. Are you getting my point? Look at here. If I take a triple product between dr r cap dot with r d theta theta cap cross product with r sine theta d phi phi cap. Am I right? Theta cap cross phi cap is r cap. R cap dot r cap 1, isn't it? It will be dr r d theta r sine theta d phi. Let's take magnitude. Is that okay? That is defined like this. Your volume element, it is defined like this. I too forgot. I used to take just this one. So we shall grab and we shall proceed. Okay? That's better. Now, this is volume element in spherical polar coordinate. Now you better write this one like this. Look at here, HR, according to this one, HR, H theta, H phi, DR, D theta, D phi. Isn't it? That's the best idea. So that I can generalize this one to cylindrical coordinate, isn't it? I don't have to write any of them. I'm going to write similar expression for cylindrical coordinate. I'm going to proceed. Okay, just observe the pattern here. Wait a second. Once you have displacement vector, area vector, and volume element, so what is the next one? Next one is defining the gradient. Okay, gradient of a scalar. Again, this needs a derivation. Okay, starting from Cartesian coordinate, you have to change the variable, you have to transform. I think that's not that easy. So let me write directly. R cap dou t by dou r plus, so theta cap divided by r dou t by dou theta. Now you have to write t in terms of r theta phi. Is that okay? Earlier I have written my scalar as a function of x, y, z, isn't it? Now you have to write in terms of r theta phi plus phi cap by r sine theta dou t by dou phi, isn't it? Again, it is little hectic to remember, but the best idea, r cap by hr dou t by dou r plus theta cap by h theta dou t by dou theta plus phi cap by h phi dou t by dou phi. Is that okay? And I'm going to generalize this one too. I mean, I'm going to write the same step for cylindrical coordinate. So this is the gradient definition. Now, do you remember, suppose t is equal to r, or t is written as root of x square plus y square plus z square. So finding the gradient in Cartesian coordinate would be lengthy. Are you getting my point? You have to take derivatives. So now look at here, what is this one? This is r, isn't it? If this is r, what is its gradient? Now look at here, t is a function of r alone, not on theta and phi. That's why this part becomes 0. What it will be? R cap by 1 dou r by dou r, that is nothing but r cap. You can write in one step. Is that okay? That's why whenever we need, we have to go for that coordinate system and we have to choose our expression from that coordinate system. Okay? So you have to do the problem in the simplest step. I mean, yeah. Now next one. So next one is, now actually, so I forgot this one. Now what I remember is I first write this kind of expression. Is that okay? Then I'll write like this. Is that okay? Because again, it's very difficult to remember that expression. So that's why let me first write in terms of your HR hex theta H phi, that becomes 1 by HR hex theta H phi. Is that okay? So dou by dou R of, again, so whenever you take the expression for divergence in the spherical polar coordinate, you have to write V in terms of Vr, V theta, V phi. Okay, you have to write Vr into R cap plus V theta into theta cap plus V phi into phi cap. Is that okay? You better write this expression here because I am going to refer into that one. Dou by dou R of, look at here, Vr, Vr H theta H phi plus dou by dou theta of V theta HR H phi. Are you getting the mnemonics? Dou by dou phi of V phi HR H theta. I don't remember the direct expression actually. I remember like this. Again, you can even we can derive in the generalized way, okay? So just see curvilinear coordinate in any book, in any mathematical physics book, you will see this expression. Okay, they may use H1, H2, H3, Q1, Q2, Q3 or U1, U2, U3 like that. Okay, let me generalize this one, the whole story, let me generalize. We shall write in a generalized symbol. Okay, so now what is this one? 1 by R square sin theta, 1 R R sin theta. So dou by dou R of, what is H theta H phi? Sin theta will come out actually. R square Vr. Just check it out. Plus HR H phi R will come out. R will come out, am I right? Dou by dou theta sin theta V theta. Check it out. HR H theta. Sorry, HR H theta. Again, R will come out. Look at here, this is little hectic to remember directly. Even after you divide with this one, little hectic to remember. Again, derivations are needed, okay, to prove this one. I mean, how to write this expression. From Cartesian coordinate, we have to take the transformation. That's what we have done, remember. Starting from the beginning, we have done the transformation from Cartesian coordinate only. But here I am defining directly. Suppose if you want to take, again, so what is this one? First part, any idea? What is first part? Yeah, let me take, suppose V vector is equal to R into R cap. Is that okay? Or sometimes V vector is written as R vector. No, don't write R vector as X, X cap, Y, Y cap, Z, Z cap. Write that one as R into R cap in spherical polar coordinate. You can write like this. Right? Position vector, that's R into R cap. Position vector direction is along R cap, radially outward, isn't it? So now look at here, if you want to take divergence, look at here, what would happen? Del dot V. Now only Vr exists, V theta and V phi are 0. If you see the same vector, R vector, in the what you call spherical polar coordinate, you will see it like this, isn't it? There is no only Vr, Vr equal to R itself. That's why, so that becomes dou by dou R of, speak up, R square into R, R cube, 1 by R square, other parts are 0, isn't it? That is 3. You can write still more simpler way. Okay, obviously this is simple in Cartesian coordinate also. Okay, suppose if you take r cube like that, r cube into r cap like that, then obviously this will be the simplest one. R vector is okay, we can do that one, dou vx by dou x, dou vy by dou y, 1 plus 1 plus 1, it will give very simpler way. But here, so in most of the case, you better to go for this coordinate system, remember. So next one is gradient, divergence and curl. So del cross v, again this also you better to remember in terms of hr, h theta, h phi. 1 by hr, h theta, h phi okay, hr r cap, h theta theta cap, h phi phi cap, dou by dou r, dou by dou theta, dou by dou phi, again wait a second. Okay, again V should be written like this. Okay, V R R cap, V theta theta cap, V phi y phi phi cap, H theta V theta, H phi V phi. That is curl in case of spherical polar coordinate, 1 by r square sine theta, what would happen? R cap, r theta cap, r sine theta, phi cap, dou by dou r, dou by dou theta, dou by dou phi, yeah. Vr, r v theta, r sine theta, v phi. Remember, there are many questions where you have to directly use this one. Okay? They'll give the question in that particular coordinate. I mean, suppose they may give vector potential. They may ask, what is the magnetic field? Magnetic field is curl of vector potential. That's it. Okay? But you have to do those problems in that particular coordinate system. You have to remember this one, okay? Not this one. You better start with this one. It will not take much time to convert, okay? Again, the next one. Again, Laplacian. I better remember, define Laplacian also, because I haven't done that Laplacian earlier. So, what is Laplacian in case of Cartesian coordinate? Del square, Laplacian of a scalar. Dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square. Now we better to write in terms of hr, h theta, h phi. That is, again I better to write it here. Again, you have to write your scalar in terms of r theta phi. Okay. So then del square of scalar, that's equal to 1 by again hr, h theta, h phi. Dou by dou r of yeah h theta h phi divided by h r again dou by dou r of t first part. Can you grab this one? So can you extend dou by dou theta of, wait a second, hr h phi divided by h theta. Now are you getting the pattern? Dou by dou theta of t. So third part is dou by dou phi hr h theta whole divided by h phi, h factor correspond to phi, so dou t by 2 of 5. This is outside. Again, so whenever we need, we should take this one, okay? Let us not waste time. Again, now look at here. Now it is very better to remember your Laplacian directly, because this is lengthy. Is that okay? What is Laplacian in spherical polar coordinate? Any idea? We have used that one in case of Schrodinger equation. Del square t 1 by r square? No. What is Laplacian directly? 1 by r square dou by dou r square dou t by dou r. Okay. So, I mean most of the case you need this one. T will be the function of r alone in many cases. Then only this part will be non-zero. Okay, at least you should know first part. So 1 by r square sine square theta dou by dou theta sine theta dou t by dou theta plus 1 by r square, no, r square sine theta here. Right? Here r square sine square theta. Yeah, that's correct. R square sine square theta dou square by dou phi square of. You better remember directly, because again writing this one itself is lengthy, isn't it? But in all other case you better first start with this one. One by r square dou by dou r square dou t by dou r, one by r square sine theta dou by dou theta sine theta dou t by dou theta, one by r square sine square theta dou square t by dou phi square. Okay. In many cases, you will need only this part, okay? At least, if you can't remember the whole, at least remember this one. And we are going to solve the Laplace equation in the third chapter, okay? Again, so not exactly solving, we are going to solve by some trick. And we are going to solve exactly also in some part, okay? Second chapter is to solve Laplace. This is a Laplacian of a scalar. Laplace equation means del square t equal to 0. We call this kind of equation as Laplace equation. We call this one as spherical harmonics. Solution of Laplace equation is named as spherical harmonics. Okay? Yeah. Yeah, you better to remember Laplacian directly. Now, what I do here is, let me define my coordinate system. Now, this is orthogonal coordinate system. Again, yeah, I forgot one more thing. So, how do you define your r cap, theta cap, phi cap? Am I right? X cap, y cap, z cap. Suppose this is r. Okay. So, what is this one? If this is the point, at this point radially outward, that is r cap, can I write like that? R cap direction, radially outward, this is the origin. So, this is r. So, this was theta, this was phi, am I right? This was phi. So, now this is r cap direction. Now, remember you need this imagination, okay? You need this imagination or if you keep solving the problem, you will get this idea, r cap. What is theta cap? Theta cap is perpendicular to this one. Theta cap is perpendicular to this one. But this r cap and theta cap should be in that plane. Can you just imagine this plane like a door? This plane, the plane that I have drawn, this plane. Okay, just imagine that plane like a door. This r cap and theta cap will be on that plane. Phi cap will be perpendicular to that one. Phi cap will be perpendicular to this one. This is phi cap. So that if you write r cap cross theta cap, you should get phi cap in a cyclic order. Similarly, theta cap cross phi cap, you should get r cap. Phi cap cross r cap, you should get theta cap in the cyclic order. Just like x cap cross y cap is equal to z cap. So it should work like this. Now look at here, that r cap, theta cap, phi cap they depends on the point in space. Am I right? If you take different point in space, you are getting r cap, theta cap, phi cap, all three unit vectors. They will take different direction. Okay, that is the difference, I mean, from the Cartesian coordinate. In Cartesian coordinate, x cap, y cap, z cap are fixed, remember, it will never change. So, but here it will change, remember. Okay. Now, wait a second, let me give some more idea here. Again, later while discussing the problem, again, let me explain this one. This is x cap, okay. Now, let me just concentrate on y cap and z cap, I mean, y z plane. Suppose I have a point here, my point is here. Now, what is my r cap, what is my theta cap, what is my phi cap? I have point on y cap, on y axis. Now, this is your r. R is a radial vector of that point. Is that okay? Let me call this point as P. So, now, what is theta? This is r, this is your position vector of this point P. Okay. This is r cap. Isn't it? This is theta. What is theta cap? Should be perpendicular to r cap. Wait a second. Now, the question is, yeah, theta cap is perpendicular to r cap, but there are many, infinitely many perpendicular to r cap. Am I right? Are you getting my point? Which perpendicular? So, that should be the plane containing this r vector and z cap. Can I say like that? Theta cap is perpendicular to r cap, but it should be in the plane containing r vector and z cap. That's why I told you to imagine this one kind of a door, this whole thing. Imagine this one kind of a door that you can just open it like this. This plane, whatever I have drawn, this plane, it contains r vector as well as z. Am I right? Plane containing two vectors. So now look at here. Here also, r vector, this is point P, r vector and z cap. The plane containing r vector and z cap is zy plane. That's why, yeah, theta cap is perpendicular to r cap, again, in that plane. Now, the question, again, why I haven't taken theta cap upside, okay? Again, that's a convention. Is that okay? So, suppose if you are measuring theta like this, take theta cap like this. You can imagine like that. You are taking phi like this. You are measuring phi like this. That's why phi cap will be like this. Wait a second. Now, r cap is along y cap in this case, in this situation. I need this one while taking the dipole problem like that, okay? Theta cap, what is theta cap direction? Minus z cap. Look at here, downward, isn't it? In z y plane, so perpendicular to y cap in this direction, minus z cap. What is phi cap? R cap cross theta cap. Or you prefer what you call thumb rule, am I right? R cap cross theta cap. So phi cap is along that is perpendicular to zy plane into the board, that will be minus x cap, am I right? Minus x cap. Just take this as an example so that you will get clear picture how those r cap, theta cap, phi cap will work. And we need this idea, okay? In case of dipole problem, we are going to use this one frequently. Over. Imagine this one kind of a door, okay? That's very nice idea. So that you can just turn that around. If you change phi means you are just turning that door, isn't it? Again, extend this idea, leave some space, take a point on x-axis, define all of those three. Okay, extend this idea, leave some space and do it yourself. On z-axis, what would happen? This is r cap. Obviously, from origin to that point, that is r cap, outward from that origin. Okay, so then how do you define theta cap? Then pi cap will be along. Why? Again, now why? Isn't it? Now you don't need other two unit vector actually. That will never come if you try to study this situation. Okay? You can write your r vector as r into r cap or z into z cap. R will be equal to z here. Am I right? Look at here. You will never need other two coordinates actually. So other two unit vector. Okay? Yeah. So little ambiguous. But what about minus here? Somewhere here? You have to take it like this. This is r cap. Then this is theta cap. Then again, r cap cross theta cap, I think outward, isn't it? R cap cross theta cap, or how do you do? No, r cap cross theta cap. Screw is coming out. What is your thumb rule? No, that's correct. Screw is going in. Pi cap is into the board. Just try to locate a different point and just see how r cap, theta cap and pi cap varies. Okay, that's very important. Now what I do here is I am going to generalize the whole story. Let me take some curvilinear coordinate, but orthogonal coordinate system. Orthogonal means just like r cap, theta cap, pi cap are orthogonal to each other. X cap, y cap, z cap were orthogonal to each other. Same way, your rho cap, pi cap, z cap, in case of cylindrical coordinate, they are orthogonal to each other. We call this one as orthogonal curvilinear coordinate. That's better. Is that okay? So now, again, I'm going to generalize this one. Let me take E1 cap, E2 cap, E3 cap as unit vector, and they are perpendicular to each other. Is that okay? And U1, U2, U3 as your variables. Variables means x, y, z, r, theta, phi, or rho, phi, z. Okay, let me just, these are the variables. Now let me define h1, h2, h3. Okay. In that general coordinate, generalized coordinate, I can define. So how did I start it? I have defined r vector. So r vector was written in terms of Cartesian. Am I right? So let me not take that one because I don't know what is the transformation equation. I'm writing generally. Let me start with the dl vector. What is this one? H1, du1, e1 cap. Just check it out. Isn't it? That's how we have written. Plus h2, du2, e2 cap. Plus h3, du3, e3 cap. That's the best way. Okay? Yeah. So he is asking about limit of integration. Okay. I hope you know that one. Okay. We already discussed in a spherical polar coordinate, theta will run from 0 to phi, phi will run from 0 to 2 phi, r will run from 0 to infinity. Never ever run r from minus infinity to plus infinity. Radial distance, always positive. Is that okay? Yeah. Now look at here. So, one is dl vector, next one is, I think dA1, dA2, dA3. Usually we prefer three different ones. dA1, E1 cap, that is H2, H3, DU2, DU3, like that right as well. So then the D2, I think we have written H1, H2, H3, DU1, DU2, DU3, generalization. Gradient, write it yourself. E1 cap by H1, dou by dou U1. Plus E2 cap by H2, dou by dou U2, plus E3 cap by H3, dou t by dou u3. Again, I haven't defined what is h1. H1 is dou r by dou u1 divided by mod of dou r by dou u1. Similarly, h2, h3. Yeah, I'm just taking whatever we need, okay? I'm not getting into detail. Yeah. Del dot 1 by h1, h2, h3. Write down this one, okay? Dou by dou u1, v1. V vector should be written as V1 E1 cap plus V2 E2 cap plus V3 E3 cap H2 H3 plus dou by dou U2 V2 V2 H1 H3 plus dou by dou U3 V3 H1 H2. Check it out. Curl 1 by h1, h2, h3, h1, e1 cap, h2, e2 cap, h3, e3 cap, dou by dou r, sorry, why I have written dou by dou r, dou by dou u1, dou by dou u1, dou by dou u2, dou by dou u3, okay, shall I write here, h1, v1, H2 V2, H3 V3. Similarly for Laplacian. Okay. Now let us write for cylindrical coordinate. By just taking all of this idea, let us write for cylindrical coordinate. Just take the pattern. Very important thing, okay? Wait. Over. Let me take cylindrical coordinate, we shall finish out. So I have to write, actually he is going to take rho as, he will not write rho, he will write S in throughout this book. Why? Rho we are going to use for charge density. Is that okay? So that's why. So he will prefer H, yes, in place of rho, usually the coordinate, one of the coordinate is rho, rho phi z, am I right? That's how we write, but he will take it as yes, because yes looks like rho, isn't it? Like that, okay? Hs, H phi, Hz, 1, yes, 1. In place of rho, I am writing yes. Just recall it. Okay, wait a second. We shall start with Cartesian again. So, we shall take the transformation. Cartesian coordinate, x cap, y cap, z cap. Is that okay? Now, look at here. Any point in space. Yeah, this is your radial vector. Sorry, this is your, yeah, position vector of that point. But that is defined as, look at here, yeah, your phi coordinate is same as earlier, okay? pi coordinate is same as earlier. Is that okay? So z is this one. Z coordinate is Cartesian z coordinate. Pi coordinate is your spherical polar pi coordinate. But one more coordinate, that is perpendicular distance from z axis, that we call as s or rho. Actually, we used to call it as rho, but here we are writing it as s. What is that one? Perpendicular distance from that one. So that's why this is written as s phi z. Any point in space that is defined by s phi z, and transformation from Cartesian coordinate is equal to s x is equal to. So now if this is s, this should be s. Now what is x and what is y? X equal to s cos phi, just check it out. Y is equal to s sin phi. Z is equal to z, because when you take transformation from Cartesian coordinate, Cartesian z axis is same as your cylindrical z axis, isn't it? You can define phi is equal to tan inverse of y by x, and s is equal to s. How do you define s? S x square plus y square, root of x square plus y square, just check it out. Z is equal to z. So inverse transformation. When you square and add, look at here, what would happen? Cos square phi plus sin square phi 1. S square equal to x square plus y square. Okay? This is the transformation equation. Again, entire step is same as whatever we have done for our spherical polar coordinate. We have to start with r vector. So s cos phi x cap plus s sin phi y cap plus z into z cap. Okay, then we have to start defining all unit vector everything. Using this one, I can define h s, that's equal to dou r by dou s, mod of dou r by dou s, that will be one. You can check it out. Okay, using that one, I can define h phi dou r by dou phi mod of dou r by dou phi, that's equal to s. You can check it out. Hz obviously dou r by mod of dou r by dou z, that's equal to 1. That's why I have written 1 s 1. Because now entire expression, other expression will be written in terms of them. Quickly. Yeah. So you better quickly write the range of phi. Phi will be from 0 to 2 phi. Okay. So z will be from minus infinity to plus infinity. So z is same as Cartesian z. So then s will be from again 0 to infinity. That's the range of all coordinates. Okay. Now quickly start writing dl vector. Hs ds s cap plus h phi d phi phi cap plus hz dz z cap. What is this one? Quickly. Ds s cap plus s d phi phi cap plus dz z cap. Okay, usually most of the case da phi is very less used, but da z is used sometimes. Okay, I mean area vector along s cap direction, what is this one? Other two, h phi hz, speak up, d phi dz. That's how we write other two. Just write the unit vector corresponds to that and write other two h and that derivatives. Are you getting this idea? Wait a second, let me write dA area vector along s cap direction, that is h phi hz d phi dz. Is it okay? Remember like that, mnemonics. Other two. Just you have to write other two. Now, what is this? H5? Yes. HZ1? Yes. D5? DZ. S cap. Area vector along X cap. It will be like this. Similarly, DA vector along phi cap. This is very less frequent, okay? HS, HZ, DS, DZ. That's just DS, DZ, phi cap. Now, DAZ, this is sometimes we need this one, okay? This one, along Z cap. What is this one? HS, H5, DS, D5. So, S, DS, D5, Z cap. This is needed somewhere, okay? Area element or infinitesimal. Area vector along Z cap. Wait, what is the next one quickly? DTO, HS, H5. HZ, DS, D5, DZ, am I right? What is this one? Yes, DS, D5, DZ. Not S square, okay? Don't make any mistake here. That is your volume element. So, next one is gradient. S cap by HS, that's equal to 1, dou by dou S of T plus S cap, phi cap by S, because H is equal to S here, phi cap by S, dou by dou S of T plus Z cap by 1, dou by dou phi. Yeah, that's correct. Similarly, other two. Whenever I need, I'm going to write. Okay. Again, I'm going to write in terms of HS, H5, HZ only. That's very comfortable. Then I'm going to transform. I'm going to substitute them. So, cylindrical coordinate system. You better write S, phi, Z are variable. S cap, phi cap, Z cap are your unit vector. These are your scale factor. And you can write all expression using only these three. This reset, isn't it? All expression, entire expression. Okay? And remember Laplacian also. Okay? In the same. Just extend this one. See the book and write down Laplacian directly. Somewhere we need that Laplacian. Somewhere there is a question of cylindrical symmetry where you need to do that. You need to solve sometimes that Laplace equation. Okay? Extend this one. Okay? Write other three. What is this one? So divergence of a vector, so curl of a vector, and Laplacian of a scalar. Write down these three later, okay? Yeah, I wanted to talk about one more. What is that? Again, unit vector. That's very important. Am I right? S is this one. Your S cap is like this. Once you imagine this one kind of a door, you can do it very easily. Okay, this is Z cap then. Obviously, Z cap is same as this one. These two are perpendicular, okay? Now, what is phi cap? Perpendicular to this door. So, if you take this one like a door, okay? So, your phi cap will be perpendicular to this one. That's it. Okay. Z cap and S cap are on that plane. S cap is along this direction. The perpendicular that you are going to draw to Z cap along the direction outward from the Z cap. Okay, so Z axis, if you take that one as a reference, outward from the Z cap and perpendicular to Z cap, outward from the Z cap, perpendicular to Z cap. That is your S cap direction. Okay. Now try these problems, okay? Problem number 1.38, have a note on that one. And I'm going to share one web page from Wolfram Alpha. They have done very well. Have a note on this one, okay? That means you should be able to write X cap, Y cap, Z cap in terms of R cap, theta cap, phi cap, and vice versa. And somewhere it is needed in some problem. It is needed. Is that okay? One in terms of other. So then, again, same thing in case of, again, X cap, Y cap, Z cap in terms of R cap, sorry, S cap, phi cap, Z cap. Z cap equal to Z cap. Yeah, I know one of them. Z cap equal to Z cap. Yeah, that expressions are needed, okay? So 1.39 and 1.40. 1.40 is the very nice problem. It will give whole idea about those spherical polar coordinate, okay? So little lengthy maybe. 1.39. Do 1.39. Problem number 1.39, I mean 39th problem, okay, and 1.40, okay, and again in the cylindrical coordinate, do 1.42 is this one, okay, have a note on problem number 1.42, is that okay? These two are again just finding the relation, then 1.43, do 1.43. It's 1.40, 1.43. It will give clear picture about that coordinate system. Try them. Let me try it later. Okay. So take a break and we shall continue. Now, if you just go to XY plane by putting Z equal to 0, you will go to plane polar coordinate. Z equal to 0, make Z equal to 0, you will go to plane polar coordinate transformation. I haven't discussed anything about plane polar coordinate. Is that okay? Whenever we need, we shall take that one. Is that okay? Plane polar coordinate is a kind of special case of that one, okay? So, how to go for plane polar coordinate from what you call your spherical polar coordinate? Any idea? Theta equal to 90 degree, isn't it? You can quickly go for it. If theta equal to 90 degree, again Z equal to 0. Z equal to R cos 90. So, our plane polar coordinate is a special case of this. Where in plane polar coordinate, only thing that we are going to define is our area vector and length element. Yeah, I better to quickly do that one. Just, so plane polar. So, theta, r, any point is represented by r comma theta, am I right? Area vector is r dr d theta. Do you remember? I just argued earlier. Just see that one, okay? So, then, your dl vector is, again, if this is r comma theta, this is r cap, this is theta cap. I think I have taken this one in while solving classical mechanics problem, isn't it? So this is r cap, this is theta cap. Is that okay? This is your initial line. We call this one as initial line. It is plane polar cone. DL vector is, again, same as earlier, dr r cap plus r d theta theta cap. Remember, from this one we defined velocity vector. Just recall. I think these two are sufficient. Anyway, volume doesn't exist on a plane, isn't it? You don't need volume element. Maybe sometimes you may need to do what you call line integral, okay, on some curvature, on some circle. Then you have to go for that particular point. Is that okay? And there are questions, just see that one, okay, line integral in some particular coordinate like this. Okay? Yeah, so quickly take a break. We shall continue.